How many reps for plyometric training? How many reps for plyometrics? Today we talk about how many repetitions should you do in a plyometric training. This is dependent on your training goal. Also, you need to understand the neurological as well as the metabolic requirements for plyometric training, the influence of different rest periods, and I also want to give my own experiences with plyometric training and see how that is a little bit different from what you sometimes read in the literature. So, how many reps should you do for plyometric training? The answer is, as always, it depends on your goal. However, we need to start by understanding the neural and metabolic requirements for an optimal plyometric training. What does that mean? So for a plyometric training to be effective, it needs to be a high neural stimulus with no to very little fatigue. That means high stimulus, plus the duration shouldn't be too long that it elicits fatigue. From a metabolic standpoint also, plyometrics require a high activation of the phosphagen system, so the ATP-CP system. That system gives energy for, let's say, 6 to 10 seconds. So everything we do needs to be somewhere between maximum of 6 to 10 seconds. From that we can conclude the activities we do in plyometric training should not be longer than 6 seconds, maximum 10 seconds, and should produce very little fatigue. Another aspect here is that we have inter and intra-serial rest periods. I haven't seen that being talked about very often in plyometric training. However, let's understand, inter-serial rest is the rest between sets. So you do a set, then you have a rest, and then you do the next set. So that's the inter-serial rest. This information we find very often in the literature. However, the intra-serial rest is the rest between repetitions. Yeah, so if we perform a repetition and then we have a rest of, let's say, 2 seconds or 4 seconds or 6 seconds, whatever it might be, this is the intra-serial rest. So in plyometric training, it depends very much on the activity you're choosing, whether there is an intra-serial rest or not. If we look at, for example, hurdle jumps, where you jump over hurdles, which is a repeated activity, there's no intra-serial rest. On the other hand, if we do box jumps, there is an intra-serial rest because you jump up, go back down, and jump again. So the activity you are choosing has also an influence on how many repetitions you can do. Remember, you can do six seconds. So if you do hurdle jumps, you are much more limited than if you do box jumps. Concluding, to make a complicated topic short and simple. So the amount of repetitions you do is depending on the activity, whether there's an intra-serial rest or not. And it should be within 6 seconds. Yeah, so if you do your hurdle jumps, you shouldn't be doing 10 or 15. You're just simply exceeding 6 seconds, which produces too much fatigue for the plyometric training to be effective. If you're looking at activities where you have some intra-serial rest, so that could be box jumps or it could be counter movement jumps, so you jump, you have a short rest of 2, 3, 4 seconds and you jump again, then the repetitions can be a bit higher. So let's make it simple. For box jumps, for example, you can do up to 10 repetitions, and for hurdle jumps, let's do 4 or 6 repetitions. So what you read normally in the literature is somewhere 6 to 10 repetitions, which I've just outlined. However, from my experience with my athletes, we use the counter movement jump to monitor the readiness of the athletes. We do that on a force plate and then we measure the velocity as well as the rate of force development. However, what I found is that if my athletes do counter movement jumps with a maximum effort, I can see that they are able to do 4 to 5 maximum repetitions. So what you can see is if they do more than that, 8, 9, or 10, you can see the velocity decreases, the rate of force development decreases, which is an indicator that the plyometric training is not effective anymore. So what that has taught me over time is that it is very much dependent on the effort. So what you read in the literature, 6 to 10, is not always correct, because I've seen that my athletes, if they do 4 repetitions, they start to fatigue. So I would much rather break it down into more sets of 4 repetitions than doing 6, 8, 10 repetitions at a stretch. So to wrap it up, how many reps should you do in plyometric training? Due to the high neural activation and low fatigue that you want to have in your plyometric training, as well as the metabolic demands, which is the activation of the phosphagen system, the ATP-CP system, the activity should not exceed 6 seconds to, let's say, 10 seconds, which makes the total amount of repetitions fairly low. So we're talking about 4 to 6 repetitions, or somewhere 6 to 10 repetitions, depending on the activity and on the effort, as I've outlined before. So an exception to the rule is, again, if we're looking at different goals. So we spoke about if we use plyometric as it's intended to be used for activating the nervous system. However, in some sports, you also need to have the ability to last the plyometric effort. So if I think about a sport like tennis, where we constantly have the split step, that is also an exception where we need to do multiple repetitions within a longer period of time, or also with an incomplete rest. Very similar to that boxing, you see the same thing, that there is always some plyometric activity, low-level plyometric activity, but for an extended period of time. So what happens here is that we probably need to train a little bit different, but also then the goal is different. The goal is not maximum activation of the nervous system. The goal is then to be able to last these activities. So this is when something comes in like this aerobic plyometrics, so that plyometrics are used for a longer period of time in a circuit training fashion. Yeah, so a few repetitions, incomplete rest, another few repetitions, but that trains different physical qualities. So that is not the power production side and the high neural stimulus, it's more the ability to last. These are exceptions, and then plyometrics can also be performed for higher repetitions with incomplete rest. But again, different goal and different adaptations. So these kind of training will not make you any more powerful or any more faster.